Hello, dear participants of faculty training program. Welcome to the session of Mail Merge. I am Dr. M. N. Sheller from Department of Computer Science, KTHM College, Nasik. In this presentation, we will see what is Mail Merge, how to use Mail Merge facility to prepare letters, mailing labels and envelopes. First, we'll discuss what is mail merge. Mail merge is a method of taking data from a database or spreadsheet or any other form of structured data to prepare letters, mailing labels, envelopes and name tags. Mail merge is nothing but creating a single document or letter that is to be delivered to multiple or mail to multiple persons at the same time. Means if you want to prepare a letter that contains similar instructions, similar document, and that is to be addressed to different persons. At that time, this mail merge facility is to be used. Whenever you want to prepare a mail merge, two important files are required. First is, we require a database of person to whom we have to address that mail. Second file is the content of the mail or instructions or and format that is to be delivered to this multiple persons. So mail merge is useful for whom? If you are employer, you may have to prepare interview call letters to several candidates. Means we have to send common instructions to all candidates at the same time. If you are employer, then sometimes you have to send common instructions or common notices to all employees of the organization. If you want to send meeting invitations to all employees and outside visitors, means we want to mail a same document to multiple person. If you are industrialist or businessman, you may have to send common mails to numerous person or customers regarding promotion of your products or advertisements. Or you may have to greet to several customers or suppliers at the same time through mail or letters. If you are a teacher, you may have to forward common notices and instruction through mail that address to several students. Sometimes you may have to communicate with all parents simultaneously about academic performance and attendance of their ward. If you are a researcher, you are collecting data from several users same time, means same form or same document we have to forward to multiple person at the same time. So at that time, this mail merge facility is used. Now, let us see how to create a mail merge, how to create single letter that is to be delivered or mailed to multiple person. Let us start now. To mail merge, we take an example of inviting parents of students in our college to attend a meeting for reviewing performance and attendance of their wards. Means we have to send a common letter to all parents of our students. So means We need to prepare two files. One is a document file, that is a letter to be mailed to all parents. And second one is the mailing database, where we have to specify the address of all parents and other information. Let us see, this is the first file where we specify here two. Here we'll write the name and address of all parents, then subject, dear, your parent name will come, your ward studying in, here we have to specify the class at our college, and secured dash dash marks. Marks, percentage of marks is to be specified here. And his overall percentage of attendance for lectures and practical is, the percentage of attendance is also to be specified here. Means we need to specify the different fields, and that we have to take from the mailing database. This document file we stored as a mail letter in Word file. Now let us come to second file, that is a containing mail database, that we will take Excel file. This is an Excel file which whose name is mail database, which contains a different columns. First is the stud F name, that is the first name of student, parent F name, first name of parent, L name means last name, address of parent, city, class of the student, marks secured in first semester as we have mentioned, percentage of attendance in first semester. So these are the different fields we have specified as in a first row. Then from second row onwards, we fill the data. Means here we see six records are entered already. That is, we have to send a letter to all these six parents. Now this letter is stored in Word file. Let us see now. This is the letter and this is a mailing database. Now we'll start with mail merge. To start mail merge, select the mailing option in Word document. Then go to start mail merge option. There are different options: letters, email messages, envelopes, labels, directory. Means this type of mail merging can be possible. Means we can send letters, we can send email messages, we can prepare the envelopes, we can prepare the labels, address labels actually, and directory. These are the five different types of mail merge options. Now, instead of selecting the particular option, we'll go step by step mail merge wizard option. I click on step by step mail merge wizard. Now mail merge is to be done in six different steps. This is a step one of six. What is the first step? Select the document type. Which type of document you want to prepare? Now letter or email or envelope like this. Now in this example, we are sending letters to parent. Means we have to select letters. Then this letter is already prepared. Go to the second step, that is the next step is a starting documents. Now we have to select starting document. Now there are three options specified. Use the current document, means this is a current document, or you may start a template, means already templates are there, you select from predefined template. And third option is start from existing document, means other than this you have to select a different document. Now I select use current document means this is the letter you want to forward to all parents, right? Next, select recipient. Third step is select the recipients to whom we have to send this letter. Now these recipients are in to be stored in database, as we have taken an Excel file, that is a spreadsheet file, and there we use. Now use an existing list, use name and address from database. We can browse and select the file, or you can select from Outlook contacts, or you can type a new list here directly. But now it's better to select the existing, browse. Now we select that particular document which is there. Now we select the Excel file where the database of mailing addresses is stored. I select this file, mail database. Now in this database, there are multiple sheets. There might be multiple sheets. Now currently there is only one sheet. You select from which sheet you want to select the database. Then also we select whether first row of that sheet data contains column header. Yes, as you see, first row is the column headers, right? So we are selecting this file. So we say check this, first row is column headers. Okay, so now automatically you will get the list of all mail merge recipients. Now you select the list of recipients to whom we have to send this letter. Now at present all are selected. You can select the particular parent names to whom we have to send the letters. Now at present there are 6. I select all. Then say OK. So now this is about the third step. Now you go to the next step, write your letter. Now here if you see, if currently we have to write the letter. Already letter is prepared, only we have to place the fields at appropriate places. Now here you want to place the name of parent. I select, go to the insert merge field, parent first name. We select parent first name, space. See, these are the name of fields which were the first row column names automatically added in this particular drop down. So parent first name, had given a space, then select last name, enter. Then we want to select the address, space, or city name. I give enter, select city. So means here this name of the fields are inserted at appropriate places. Then next we go to here, we have to write dear, and then we have to specify name of the parent. So I use insert parent first name. Next is your ward studying in. Here we have to specify name of the student. Here we have to specify the class. Here your ward. Then here you insert name of the student. So you'll get the name of the student, studying in, name of the class, at our college, and secure, where we have to specify, insert merge field, marks. So these are the merge fields, marks in first semester and his overall percentage of attendance for lectures and practicals is your percentage of attendance. Attendance. So this is, we have inserted merge fields at appropriate places. So this document is prepared. Next, preview your letters. Fifth step, you see here the letter is prepared. You can go to the next, previous, first record, next, second record. Automatically, merge fields are replaced by their appropriate content. So you see your ward, name of the student, studying in TYBCOM at our college and secured. This is the marks, percentage of marks. Here if you see number of decimal places, now actually we want to have decimal places up to 2 digits. We will have to do formatting of these merge fields. Here this is kindly visit. Okay, this is about the all letters are prepared. And now next step, complete the merge. Once these 5 different documents are prepared, same document, only the appropriate values in place of merge fields are replaced. You can print this document. We can start printing. We can give the name of the printer or PDF. If you want to prepare a PDF file, you can prepare a PDF. So this PDF file will be prepared instead of going to the, now we can select this name of the file. Already this is to be overwrite. So creating PDF. So you see there 6 records were there. So 6 pages are prepared. And 6 letters are prepared. First record. This is second. And so all these letters you can take the prints and mail it. So this is how we have created letters. Now we'll come to the point of formatting the numbers. How these numbers are to be formatted in documents, that is the in a merge field. If you see in this letter, there is a marks, percentage of marks goes more number of decimal places. If you want to round it up to 2 decimal places, we need to format it. So we go to the original letter. Now here this is the original letter in mail merge. You right click here, select the toggle field codes. So this is a merge field. Here we have to specify the formatting of 2 decimal places, / / 0.00. similarly, your attendance also in terms of 2 decimal places, right click, toggle field, and / / 0.00. We have to specify the percent sign if you want to mention that this is the value in terms of percentage. Once it's over, go to again the next preview your letters after modification. You see here the marks as well as the attendance will round it up to 2 decimal places. Complete the merge. So this is about the formatting of numbers up to rounded up to 2 decimal places. For this number, you can go for more formattings again. Let us say I want to put the other information. Here I put fees paid by the student. I will insert the field. Insert fees paid. So preview the later. You will get this. All letters will be the prepared. Fees paid value will get it. Now I want to put the commas here and as well as a dollar. Come to the previous formatting again. To format again, right click on the this merge field, select the toggle field quotes. You put backslash hash dollar hash. And you see here, you will get a dollar sign with, see the next records. If you want to put commas over there, you can put commas. Go to previous again. Right click, toggle fields. To put comma, we can write dollar hash dollar comma hash hash. Now also 2 decimal places rounded off. Again, you will get comma separated values with 2 decimal places. Next record, previous record. This is how we do formatting for these numbers also. Again, you can just view merge field formatting. Backslash hash, means dollar will be attached to the number. Comma means comma separated, hash hash means you'll get a comma separated numbers, and 0.00 is used for rounded up to 2 decimal places. This is about number formatting. We have seen a document type for mail merge is letters, but there are other document types are also available. We'll see next is email messages. Now, if you want to send a common document to all parents by email, then it is necessary that in your database, you should have email ID of all parents. So this is email ID is already entered. Then we prepare, select email messages as a document type option, then go to the next step, select recipients, then write your email message. So we write the email message, what you want to write, we consider this is an email message. Then next step is preview your email. You will get this is a preview email. All merge fields are in replaced by the content from database. Next, complete the merge. So merge is completed and you want to send this all documents which are prepared to email. Now you have to select merge to email, which what is the field name where email addresses are specified, that we select. Then subject line, See, we write parents meet, it's email subject line. Then mail format. You can send the email as an attachment. You can send as a plain text in email body, or you can send as a HTML. If I select as an attachment, and then we click OK. But it is necessary that we should have configure Outlook Express in this system. Then this email will be sent by through Microsoft Outlook Express. Now, next document type is envelopes. If you are sending letters by post, then we need to print the postage address, postal address on envelopes. For that, we select document type envelopes. Then we go to the second step. Second step, here we have to change document layout. You can select envelope options, because layout of envelope is to be selected in this step. There are different sizes of envelopes which are available. You select the appropriate size. Then what is the font of the delivery address? We can select the particular font of the delivery address. What is the font of return address? You can also specify at appropriate positions. So this is the place where you have to insert email addresses, postal address, sorry. Then next, select recipient. Now we have to select the file, again that mailing database. Select this mail database. Select the sheet. Now we select all six records to create envelopes. Then next step, arrange your envelope. For envelope, we need to give address block properly. Select the address block. What format you want the address block? Now we want to match the fields at the address. So first name should be matched with parent first name. Last name will be matched with L name. There is a no suffix. City and address is there. Okay. So this is what the address is prepared. We say, because you can just go for preview these addresses. These mail addresses will be printed on envelopes. This is the address block which is inserted in the center of the envelope. Next step, preview your envelopes. This is the envelope content. This is what envelope will be created. Now, next document type is labels. If you want to create labels, then we select document type labels. Next, starting document, we select the label options. What is the size of label you want? Say like 1x4 of letter size, means 4 labels will be printed in one letter size page. Okay. Then next step, select recipients list. Already it is selected. Next, arrange your labels. So at this place we put address block. Address block will be in this format, because already fields are matched. First name match with the parent first name, last name with L name. Okay. Then we have to update all labels, because labels will be printed here. First label here, we want second label at the next record, so you will get second label. Third label will be here.
means in one page you will get four labels. I'll preview it. Means here we see labels are created, the first, second, third, fourth, in this way. Means you, this is a first page, like second, like this, and next complete the merge. In this way you can create a mail merge to prepare labels of addresses. In this way we can use a mail merge tool to produce letters, labels and envelopes of similar instructions and format that address to different persons from mailing database. Thank you.